Looking at the sun is a great way of doing astronomy. Safe solar observation, obviously looking at the nearest star, our sun, is a great pastime. And there's a lot going on in the sun in white light. So that's looking at the sun in the visible spectrum. Obviously, we've got to do this safely. The sun is an incredibly bright target to look at. Even in a small telescope, it's completely unsafe to point the instrument at the sun without the right kind of equipment. So let's take a closer look at some of the equipment and accessories you'll actually need to observe the sun. Obviously, we're going to take the telescope for granted. We're using a very small refractor here to use for our solar observation. First and foremost, safety of your eyesight should be of paramount importance, and here we're using a safe full aperture solar filter. This is an Astro Engineering Solview solar filter. It uses, instead of glass, a mylar film on the filter. The outside of it is aluminium. We've got three screws to help the retention, as well as some foam pads on the inside. We'd recommend at least two methods of retention on the telescope. Always examine the filter very carefully before you actually use it. With a mylar filter, there's no need to worry about any kind of rippling that you might get on the surface of the film there. That's actually quite normal for this type of filter, and it won't have any effect at all on the quality of the image. So really don't worry about that at all. Solar filter just fits directly to the front of the telescope here. Tweak up the screws and give it a little tug to actually make sure that it's well in position. So that's good. The telescope now is ready to be pointed at the sun, but there's a few things we've got to remember. The finder over here, for example, that's still uncapped. Now, if we point the telescope at the sun like this, there's a good chance we're actually going to lose the crosswires in the finder if we do this. So do remember to actually cap that up before you use the telescope. I do actually know a chap who set light to his beard while observing the sun when he forgot to cap the finder, so you don't want to do that. Now, there are actually some rather nice gadgets that can do a better job than merely capping it up. And here's one we've got, which is the AC466 by Astro Engineering. This is a little gadget. I'll just show you that in a little bit more detail before I put that on there. It's actually a solar finder, and it works by capping the 50mm finder that's on the telescope. So that simply fits on the front there, and actually provides us with a means of still finding the sun using this little pinhole device at the front here, casting an image of the sun on the background target so that we can actually home in on the location of the sun and make it a lot easier to find it. Well, we're on the subject of finders. Let me just show you this one as well. This is a universal solar finder. This is the AC618. Now this has a little universal base. It can actually be removed from here, this top part. You can see it's fairly similar to the one that we've got on top here, and it works by a pinhole system again. Only this one's kind of cute in that we've got a little fridge magnet kind of idea. We've got a little magnet with the target on it to allow for collimation. Now this can be fitted semi-permanently by stripping off self-adhesive tape on the bottom of the universal mount here, and putting that anywhere on the telescope that's actually convenient. But it also comes, if you don't want to mark the telescope tube, it also comes with a, if I can pull it out, a Velcro strap, so we can actually put it onto the telescope and hold it in position temporarily while we do solar observing using a Velcro strap. And that's really pretty thoroughgoing. That'll fit on telescope tubes from about 3 inches, well, frankly, the sky's the limit, up to about 16 to 20 inch tube. So that's very easy to fit to just about any telescope. It also has a, almost forgot to mention that, it also has a little stick-on target as well. So if you want to make the target permanent, you can put that little stick-on target on there as well. This is the AC667. I'll just undo it. It folds up quite nicely, you can see. Simply stick a screw into that little slot. It's got a really nice feature in that it folds, and we've got another position here that we can use with it to open it up so that it works with all different size of telescopes. Simply stick that screw in there to lock it up. Now all we do with the AC667, and this is designed to create a micro environment at the rear of the telescope, is simply put that onto the instrument in an appropriate position. Let's just lock that up and put a Velcro band around and put that into position. Probably a bit too much Velcro here, frankly. That's it. And then we can tighten it up with the screw at the top. Bingo. Now, the idea is that obviously on a sunny day when you're doing your observing, it creates an automatic shadow at the eyepiece end of the telescope. And that will actually increase the quality of your view very considerably. Not just because you as an observer are obviously not putting your eye into bright sunlight anymore, but you'll actually find that if your eye is protected when you're at the eyepiece, you're probably going to get a very considerable improvement in contrast and be able to see fine detail a lot better using the AC667. And you can see that that'll fit just about any telescope, that system. It's a totally universal idea. So there you go, a few accessories to help you make white light observations using the telescope you already have. That's the Solview filter, full aperture solar filters, available in a range of sizes. The AC667 solar shield, the AC618 universal finder, and the AC466 50mm finder conversion. That's it for now.